Austin Harriff plans to plead insanity in these gruesome, cannibal-like murders, but his attorney argues that the burden of proof to convince the jury of insanity is too high and that it violates Harriff's constitutional rights. Austin Harriff's lawyers say he was insane when he attacked John Stevens and Michelle Mishkon, stabbing and biting them in their Martin County garage and front yard. Their expert witness testified that the actual number of insanity defenses are extremely low, fewer than 1%.
The general public believes that it's used often. It's because high publicity cases, general public perceives that it's going on more often than it is, and certainly it's a very small percentage of cases.
Harriff's attorneys say the judge should overturn a 2016 law that makes a defendant prove they're insane by clear and compelling evidence. They say that's an unfair burden of proof that other defendants, those claiming self-defense, for example, don't have. And they say by telling jurors he's insane, that also removes his presumption of innocence. Prosecutors disagree.
There's certainly no discrimination against persons with mental defects or mental illnesses. They have their own statute for mental illness.
Harriff's father declined to comment.
You're not going to say anything about the latest motion, Dr. Harriff?
No.
Michelle Mishkon's sister says they don't believe Harriff is insane at all.
He's guilty of sin. He's looking for sympathy. It's a Hail Mary.
The judge says it's rather complicated. He wants to study the case law before he issues a written ruling.